Basic science represents curiosity. We decided to break it up into distinct disciplines like biology, chemistry, and astronomy. But ultimately, it's all the same kind of curiosity, which is, how did things work? How did they begin? How do they end? That is essential to the nature of what it means to be human. Science is about thinking and new ways of seeing things. Maybe there are things that we've actually described in the same way for 1,000 years, and then all of a sudden we find some discovery or some realization that says, we gotta completely rethink the way that we actually considered this. Science does that more succinctly than almost any other kind of human endeavor. And so every bit as much as we appreciate art or poetry, we appreciate science.
Yale, it's an absolutely fabulous place for scholarship. Its history is based on learning and discovery. That's why we're here.
Yale is an intellectual hub. It is a place that has a strong legacy of originating some of the most exciting new ideas.
Our mission is to create new knowledge and to transmit that knowledge through our teaching. The thrill of saying, I have this question about how the world works. Nobody knows the answer. I'm going to go out and I'm going to design the experiment or collect the data or develop the theory that answers that question and that pushes the boundaries of human knowledge. There's nothing like it.
Much of science is laborious. It's called a laboratory for a reason. And it's also very time consuming. It takes a while before we can actually see the importance of these things that we do. And in fact, what really is happening is that we're doing the slow process of thinking things through.
Science is unpredictable, and I'd like to think that institutions such as ours offer the space for the more creative, unpredictable kind of work, where we don't know what the outcome's going
to
be.
You want to be fearless and not constrained by current thinking.
If we're curious, but we're not actually ambitious, and we're not brave enough to sort of step outside of our comfort zone, then in fact, we probably won't succeed in making real progress.
The big leaps forward, the big discoveries, they often start by someone who had a very specific question about a very specific system or process, and in the course of answering that, opened up this whole new vista for us. These projects are very granular, but that is how the frontiers of knowledge expand.
When you're the first one to actually see something and you know that you're the first human being to know that this is how it works, that's an incomparable experience. It's exciting. It's really incredible to have the opportunity to do what I do. But it also tends to have, years down the road, these unexpected payoffs in which people had no idea that this simple discovery was going to actually be applied in an area that's very, very different than what they had assumed.
Without the foundational work that comes out of basic sciences, there is no applied science. There is no technology.
Curiosity-driven research at Yale and beyond has underpinned almost every technological advance that you can think of, from food production to heating and cooling to GPS to diagnostic medical imaging.
We're talking about scientific research. What we're actually talking about is an investment into the future. It's an almost guaranteed thing. People understand that the stock market goes up and down, but generally over time, your investment is going to pay off. And that is certainly the case with science.
A basic scientist tries to understand the world we live in. We seek the truth, we seek knowledge, because there's just so much out there to know.
Right now, in Yale's Faculty of Arts and Sciences, fundamental research is being done that will end up transforming our understanding of human health and disease, of neuroscience, of the quantum world, and beyond.